ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
నెక్స్ట్ వి కెన్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ సెకండ్ లా ఆఫ్ థర్మోడైనమిక్స్. సెకండ్ లా ఆఫ్ థర్మోడైనమిక్స్ what is second law of thermodynamics. Two statements here. So here mainly the first law of thermodynamics explains about law of conservation of energy. dq is equals to du plus dw. First law of thermodynamics explains about law of conservation of energy, but it fails to explain what is the direction of law of heat energy. But it fails to explain what is the direction of flow of heat energy. So in what direction the heat energy flows, in what direction the heat energy flows. So that means heat energy flows from low temperature to high temperature or high temperature to low temperature. It does not, just dq is equals to du plus dw, and it explains when the dq is positive, when the dq is negative, and when the du is positive, du is negative, when dw is positive and dw. It explains about all this, but it does not explains what is the direction of flow of heat energy. Now second law of thermodynamics explains about direction of flow of heat energy. Second law of thermodynamics explains about direction of flow of heat energy. What is its direction of flow of heat energy? Direction of flow of heat energy, so these two statements, Clausius statements and one more is Kelvin statements. Clausius statement is, these are two scientist names, Clausius and Kelvin. Clausius statement is, it is not possible to transfer the heat energy from low temperature to high temperature without the use of any external agency. So that definition is, it is impossible to transfer heat energy from low temperature to high temperature. It is impossible to transfer heat energy from low temperature to high temperature without the help of any external agency or external thing, whatever it is. So that is called Clausius statement. That means heat energy always flows from high temperature to low temperature only. It does not flow from low temperature to high temperature. If we want to transfer the heat energy from low temperature to high temperature, we must use any one external agency. Best example is in case of refrigerator. Heat energy flows from low temperature to high temperature with the help of what is external agency? Electrical energy. That is called Clausius statement. It explains about the direction of flow of heat energy. So heat energy always flows from high temperature to low temperature. That is Clausius statement. Next, Kelvin statement. What is Kelvin statement? Kelvin statement. How can you explain about this Kelvin statement? Kelvin statement means, what is the Kelvin statement is? So Kelvin statement. So it is not possible to convert total amount of heat supplied to the system, total amount of heat supplied to the system into useful work. It is not possible to convert the total amount of heat supplied to the system into useful work. So that means according to first law of thermodynamics, dq is equals to du plus dw. So in this situation du is equals to zero, that condition is not possible. So that means if this will happens, 100% efficiency must be realized in practice. What is the meaning of this meaning of this is 100% efficiency is impossible. So that is, so these are the two statements of second law of thermodynamics. Clausius statement explains about the direction of law of heat, and Kelvin statement explains about this condition. 100% efficiency is not possible. Whatever is the heat supplied, certain amount of heat energy must be wasted to increase the internal energy. Internal energy of the system must be changes. So that is the concept of this Kelvin statement. So this is Carnot second law of thermodynamics. Next, we can discuss about Carnot engine. Next, we can discuss about Carnot engine. Carnot engine. It is the reversible heat engine. Carnot's engine is the reversible heat engine that can be operated between two different temperatures. So that is called Carnot's engine. So it is the reversible heat engine that can be operated between two different temperatures. So that is called Carnot engine. So it is the reversible heat engine that can be operated between two different temperatures. So reversible process, this Carnot engine is the reversible process. Actually reversible process does not exist. If that exists, that is called Carnot's theorem, that can be exist between two different temperatures, operated between two different temperatures. So that is the situation, Carnot's engine. Let us discuss about different processes in this. We can discuss about this. So four step process it is. Carnot engine is the, so the process takes place in this is four step process. What are the processes involved in this situation is isothermal process and adiabatic process. Isothermal process and adiabatic process. Four step process is this. Two processes are expansions, two are compressions. Two are expansions and two are compressions. So that is, see here. If we draw the graph, so for the pressure and volume, so the shape of the graph is first initially this one, and next this one, and next again this one, again this one. This is the shape of the graph of this. Like this, let us say A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. This is the four step process. So at the point A, let us say the pressure is P1, volume is V1, and temperature is T1. At the point B, pressure is P2, volume is V2, temperature is T1, only temperature remains constant. Later we can discuss about this. At the point C, that pressure is P3, volume is V3, and temperature is T2. At point D, the pressure is P4, volume is V4, and temperature is T2, and again reaches to the same position. So these are the four step process: A to B, B to C, C to D, D to A. Four step process. Carnot engine. Now we can discuss particularly with one step. What is AB process? What is BC? What is CD? What is D2A? That we can discuss now. So come to the point,
Here, first process, A to B, that is, see here the temperature is T1, here also the temperature is T1. If the temperature of the system remains constant, in what situation the temperature of the system remains constant? Under what situations the temperature of the system remains constant? Isothermal process. In case of isothermal process, temperature of the system remains constant. Pressure increases or volume increases, whatever it is. So the first step is isothermal expansion. So that is A to B, isothermal expansion, first step. Because why only it is isothermal? Because the temperature of the system remains constant. It is T1 and it is also T1. So temperature of the system remains constant. So that's why it is isothermal process. So temperature, isothermal expansion. So now, what is isothermal? For example, here, in case of isothermal expansion, certain amount of gas is taken into the cylindrical vessel with the mobile piston, good conducting system, whose initial pressure is P1, volume is V1 and temperature is T1. Certain amount of gas is taken into the cylindrical vessel with mobile piston. It is now, first initially the system is placed on the source. What is the use of source? Source supplies heat energy to the system and the system expanding at constant temperature. Isothermal process actually does not happen. Of course, we are supplying heat energy, still the temperature remains constant. If it is discussed already, now if the cylindrical vessel, the certain amount of weights are placed on the piston, the weights are slowly removing. So for example, 10 kgs of weights are placed on the piston, 0.1 gram, 0.1 gram, 0. If you remove that 0.1 gram, is there any change? But this is a small change, but is negligible. If you remove in that case, that is isothermal process. Here same way, the system placed on the source. Here first case, if the system is placed on source, then source supplies, let us say Q1, amount of heat energy to the system. If the system is placed on the source, then source supplies Q1 amount of heat energy to the system. Then the system expands at constant temperature. Because isothermal process means temperature remains constant. That is the condition. So if the temperature remains constant, change in internal energy of the system must be zero at constant temperature. That means du is equals to zero. So whatever is the heat supplied, that completely converts into work done. But according to Kelvin's statement, this is not possible. But if possible, if it is possible, so dq is equals to dw. dq, what is the heat energy supplied here? Q1 is the amount of heat energy supplied. So what is the work done? What is the process it is? Isothermal process. What is the work done in isothermal process? Generally 2.303 nR T1, because the temperature at this position is T1, log V2 by V1, because final volume by initial volume. So this is the first equation. And the first process is isothermal expansion. What we are doing, if the system initially placed on the source, then the source supplies certain amount of heat energy, due to that the system expands at constant temperature. That is,
Second step is adiabatic expansion. Adiabatic expansion. Yes, it is B2C. Adiabatic process means neither heat supplied in the system nor heat taken out from the system. DQ0. Neither heat supplied to the system nor heat taken out from the system. That's why here initially where the system is placed? Initially the system is placed on the source. Now the system is removed from the source. Here the system is removed from source. And placed on non-conducting stand. The system is removed from the source and placed on the placed on the non-conducting stand. The system is non-conducting stand means neither heat supplied to the system nor heat taken out from the system. So that's why adiabatic system removed from the source and placed on non-conducting stand. That means DQ0. So that means here the pressure changes, volume changes, and temperature also changes. Pressure changes, volume changes, and temperature also changes. So work done during this process. Adiabatic process. So let us say Q1. Let us say this W1 is equals to Q1. Let us have first work done. Next to W2, in the sense W2 can be written as NR into T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1. So this is the work done in adiabatic process. We already derived the expressions for this. Work done in adiabatic process, NR into T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1. So next third one is compression. So here the graph moves like this. Compression, isothermal compression. Again, isothermal compression. So what is that? C2D. Isothermal compression. Here the temperature remains constant here. Here the temperature is T2 and here also the temperature is T2. So that's why it is isothermal process. Now the system is removed from non-conducting stand and placed on sink. What is the sink can do? It absorbs heat energy from the working substance. Sink absorbs heat energy from the working substance. That's why, because it is isothermal compression. In isothermal process, heat must be supplied. DQ never be zero and DW never be zero. Only DU0 in isothermal process. That's why the system is removed from the non-conducting stand and it is placed on the sink. System is removed from the non-conducting stand and placed on the sink, and it is placed on the sink. So now it is placed on the sink. Now come to the point here. System compressed. At constant temperature. Let us say Q2 is the amount of heat energy rejected to the sink. Here DQ is equals to DW because DU is equals to 0. So that means Q2 is equals to W3. Third work done it is. So 2.303 NRT2, because the temperature here it is T2, log V4 by V3, final volume by initial volume. But this can be written as minus 2.303 NRT2 log V3 by V4. Here the fraction must be reversed. Just it is for our convenience. 2.303 nRT2 log V3 by V4. So this is the situation. So this is isothermal compression. And final one is, fourth one is adiabatic compression. Adiabatic compression. So that is D2A. Adiabatic compression. So adiabatic compression means adiabatic process. Again the system removed from, again here the system removed from sink and placed on again and placed on non-conducting stack, because DQ0 in case of adiabatic process, DQ0 in case of adiabatic process. So therefore work done in this process is, again work done is, so let us say it is W4. So general formula, NR into T2 minus T1 by gamma minus 1. Previously here we are moving from T1 to T2, that's why T1 minus T2. Here we are moving from T2 to T1, that's why T2 minus T1. So again W4 can be written as minus NR into T1 minus T2 multiply with minus divided by gamma minus 1. This is fourth equation. This is third equation. So these are the four step process. Carnot engine is the four step process. Isothermal expansion, adiabatic expansion. Isothermal compression, adiabatic compression. So by using these four, what is the net work done, total work done? So total work done of the system. What is the total work done of the system? Here it is. So total work done is equals to net work done, W is equals to W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4, total work done. And W is equals to, W1 is nothing but Q1, heat energy must be equal to work done. W2 formula, what we got, NR into T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1 plus W3 is nothing but Q2. But it is a negative work done. We got W3 is equals to minus NRT log V3 by V4. That is, let us say it is minus Q2, because heat rejected by the substance. Q1 is the heat amount of energy supplied. Q2 is the amount of heat energy lost. So that's why minus heat. Plus Q4 is NR into T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1. These two will cancel. This plus and minus. So therefore total work done is equals to Q1 minus Q2. Total work done is equals to Q1 minus Q2. Then efficiency. Efficiency is defined as work done by heat supply. So Q1 minus Q2 by Q1. So 1 minus Q2 by Q1. This is the efficiency. But here efficiency formula is 1 minus Q2 formula, 2.303 NRT2 log V3 by V4 divided by Q1 value, 2.303 NRT1 log V2 by V1. This is the total net work done formula, because W1 is Q1 and W3 is Q minus Q2, and W2, W4 we derived now based on four step process. Net work done is given, net work done obtained is, let us say, Q1 minus Q2. What is the net work done obtained? Q1 minus Q2. So W is equals to Q1 minus Q2 by Q1. Efficiency. Efficiency, definition of efficiency is work done by heat supplied. So 1 minus, so this is efficiency, can be written as 1 minus 2.303 NRT2
log V3 by V4 divided by 2.303 NRT1 log V2 by V1, log V2 by V1. Now, here in this situation, what we can write it as? But if these two, here 2.303 cancel, NR cancel, efficiency can be written as 1 minus T2 log V3 by V4 divided by T1 log V2 by V1. But what is the efficiency formula? 1 minus T2 by T1. Actual efficiency is 1 minus T2 by T1. But here what is again log V3 by V4 log V2 by V1. Now we prove that V3 by V4 equals to V2 by V1. How can we prove is, here BC and DA are adiabatic processes. B2C and D2A are adiabatic process. From adiabatic relation between temperature and volume, what is the formula? TV power gamma minus 1 is equals to constant. From adiabatic relation between temperature and volume, TV power gamma equals to gamma minus 1 equals to constant. Then apply this relation for B2C and D2A or A2D, whatever it is. From B2C, here the temperature is T1, V1 power gamma, sorry, V2, T1, V2 power gamma minus 1 is equals to here T2, V3 power gamma minus 1. So, adiabatic relation between temperature and volume. From B2C, what is the temperature here? T1, volume is V2. Here the temperature is T2, volume is V3. So, T1 V2 power gamma minus 1 equals to T2 V3 power gamma minus 1. T2 V3 power gamma minus 1. Next, from A2D or D2A, whatever it is, there T1 V1 power gamma minus 1 is equals to, here the temperature is T1, volume is V1. Here it is, T2 V4 power gamma minus 1. As the temperature is T2, V4. For this, from B2C, we are applying adiabatic relation between temperature and volume. From A2D also, we are applying adiabatic relation between temperature and volume. The ratio of these two here, T1 V2 power gamma minus 1 divided by, so T1 V1 power gamma minus 1, that is equals to T2 V3 power gamma minus 1 by T2 V4 power gamma minus 1. T2 T2 cancel, T1 T1 cancel. So this is V2 by V1 whole power gamma minus 1 is equals to V3 by V4 whole power gamma minus 1. Both sides powers are same, and divide with the gamma minus 1 on both sides, we can get V2 by V1 is equals to V3 by V4. From adiabatic relation between B2C and D2A, what we prove that the adiabatic relation between temperature and volume is TV power gamma minus 1 equals to constant. TV power gamma minus 1 equals to constant. From B2C, T1 V2 power gamma minus 1 equals to T2 V3 power gamma minus 1 from B2C and D2A. So what we got finally, V2 by V1 equals to V3 by V4. Then substituting in this here, then eta is equals to 1 minus T2 log V3 by V4 divided by T1 log. In place of V2 by V1, what we can substitute? V3 by V4 again. Log this cancels, and finally efficiency is 1 minus T2 by T1. That is the efficiency of the Carnot engine. So this is the derivation of the Carnot engine to obtain the efficiency. Efficiency eta is equals to 1 minus T2 by T1, 1 minus E2 T2 by T1. This is the situation. Carnot engine, this is the reversible heat engine. A to B is the isothermal expansible process. A to B, how much amount of heat energy absorbed? C to D, same amount of heat energy emitted. And B to C, whatever is the changes, D to A, all the same changes must be takes place. So that's why that is called reversible heat engine. If exactly all the steps are possible, then efficiency becomes 1. But efficiency does not becomes 1. So that means it is not perfect reversible process. Definitely certain amount of energy must be wasted. So that is the meaning of this Carnot engine. And it is the Carnot efficiency. Eta equals to 1 minus T2 by T1. So page number 103, question number 41. See here, question number 41. A Carnot freezer takes heat from water at 0 degrees Celsius inside it and rejects it to the room at temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. Latent heat of ice is 336 into 10 cube joule per kg. If 5 kg of water at 0 degrees Celsius converts into ice at 0 degrees Celsius by the freezer, the energy consumed by the freezer is. So here the condition is T2 is 0 degree Celsius, that means 273 Kelvin, and T1 is 27 degree Celsius plus 273, so 300 Kelvin. First calculate freezer, that's why we have to calculate beta first of all. Beta is equals to T2 by T1 minus T2, so 273 by 300 minus 273. So 273 divided by 27. So that is approximately it is 10.111 like that. Beta is equals to. But we know beta is equals to Q by W. So W is equals to Q by beta. Q is nothing but ML by beta. What is M? 5 kgs of water. 5 kgs of water. Latent heat of fusion of ice is given as 336 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by beta is approximately considered as 10. So 5 into 336 into 10 square. 5 3 is 5 6 are 30. 18. 16 into 10 square. So that is 168 into 10 cube or 168 into 10 cube. Or 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joule. 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joule. So that is the condition. So first T1 said beta we calculated. So because it, here it mentioned Carnot freezer. That means refrigerator. So that is 10.1 approximately. Beta we know is Q by W. Or W is equals to Q by beta. So then it is. This is next to 42nd question. So these are the main questions. A Carnot engine absorbs 100 joules of heat energy from the reservoir at 127 degrees Celsius and rejects 600 joules of heat energy during each cycle. So amount of heat energy absorbed is equals to 1000 joules and heat energy rejected is equals to 600 joules. So temperature is 127 degrees Celsius plus 273, so that is equals to 400 Kelvin. So first calculate efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but Q1 minus Q2 by Q1. Q1 1000 minus 600 divided by Q1 is 1000. So 400 by 1000, so that is equals to 0.4 or 40%. 40% is the efficiency. Next, temperature of the sink. So efficiency is equals to 1 minus T2 by T1. 0.4 is equals to T2 divided by T1 is 400. So T2 by 400 is equals to 1 minus 0.4. So T2 by 400 is equals to 0.6. Then T2 is equals to 0.6 into 400, 240 Kelvin. So that is 240 Kelvin means Celsius, 240 minus 273. So T2 is equals to minus 33 degrees Celsius. Minus 33 degrees Celsius, 40% efficiency and temperature is minus 33 degrees Celsius. So these are the problems related to the Carnot engine.
ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యారంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.